you mentioned 6 months prior to the pandemic. 6 months would be about how long it would take for eviction. But just to be clear, that's if the tenant lawyered up and got a defense attorney for their eviction?
You know, not really. I mean, so I got to give a notice to a tenant 5 days. Then I take it down to the courthouse. I had to give it to the sheriff, 30-day return date. Maybe the sheriff would hit. I would say about 40% of the time it hit. And if not, got to go back and get a special process server, another 30 days.
Another 30 days. So now you're 2 months in.
Now you're 2 months in. So then you get your first court date. Maybe the tenant comes in and says, oh, I need more time to get a lawyer.
Another month return date.
Yeah. You know, initially, like about 4 years ago, it was a month. Before the pandemic, they started to say, hey, look, 14 days, come on back. But now you got 14 days. And then if that lawyer came in and if they filed motions, counter suits under the RLTO, which is very tenant friendly, very anti-landlord, so then you'd have another date and then maybe another date 30 days out. And then you'd come to an agreement because most cases do settle. And then you had a date where they would say, okay, well, we'll be out by 2 weeks from now, 3 weeks from now. And then finally they'd be out. And if the tenant didn't show up and you got your judgment, there was a stay, which meant that you couldn't take the paperwork down to the sheriff's office for 14 days, 30 days.
What was the stay for?
The stay would allow the tenant to leave after the judgment order had been entered. It gave them breathing space so that they could eliminate their items from the property.
How long was the stay on average?
You know, initially I had a lot of them that were 30 days, but again, just like the court date to come back with a lawyer, they started dropping it to about 14 or so. So, but again, another half a month. And then you'd have to take it down to the sheriff's office, and then they would go and then they would serve it. And that alone took 6 to 8 weeks.
Right.
So you could see that timeline. It's every step along the way was very painful. And all states are not like this. A lot of these states, you file your action, you go before the judge, and the judge would tell the tenant, all right, well, did you pay? No. Why not? Well, I didn't pay. All right, judgment entered, 48 hours. You know, other states are very quick about that.
That's really quick.
Yeah.
48 hours is very quick. I could see 30 days to relocate and quit the property, remove your stuff out. You'd think that the time for evictions could go up to about a year just because of the sheer volume that the court system is going to have to deal with?
Right. Well, I mean, the sheriff is going to get slammed with a deluge of these tenants that have to be served. So that's going to take a while. And then you're going to move into process server territory. And then after that, you'll get service on some, and then you get dates. But then there's going to be so many. I mean, I don't even know what Zoom court is going to look like online with, you know, 100 cases on the docket for an eviction. I think it's going to be insanity.
And when you say 100 cases on the docket for an eviction, you mean per judge?
Per judge. I mean, even beforehand, a judge might have 40 cases or 50 cases. So let's assume it just doubles. I mean, that's going to be pretty intense.
You know, I would assume probably doubling, maybe even more.
Probably. But if you figure maybe on average 10 minutes per case, 100 cases, you're going to be on that Zoom call for a long time.